Ringling slipping away. Only 40.
So no Jimmy Buffett trip through Montana would be complete without a stop here in Ringling, Montana. And it was about Ringling, Montana that Jimmy Buffett wrote the song Ringling Ringling, which appeared on his 1973 album Living and Dying in Three-Quarter Time. So a little background on the song. So Jimmy was traveling back through this area in his rental car with his friend Richard Brodigan. And they stopped off here at the town of Ringling. And while Jimmy was sitting in the bar having a beer, he made a number of observations about this dying little town, which became the basis for the song Ringling Ringling. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a little tour of Ringling. We're going to talk to a couple of the locals. We're going to learn a little bit more about Jimmy Buffett and about the people that he wrote about in that song. So stay with us here. We're going to start here with the church. We're going to see if there's a broken window up there. Something tells me that place ain't been used in years. But here we go. Let's go tour Ringling Ringling. It's a dying little town.
Church window's broken. That place ain't been used in years.
Walking up the hill to the Ringling Church, established 1914. And you could imagine that this church, 50 years ago, when Jimmy wrote the song Ringling Ringling, probably looked almost exactly as it does now. So we're gonna do a quick look around here at the church. We'll see if we can find a broken window. Let's go check it out. So I just did a complete 360 search here of the church here in Ringling. And even though I did not find any broken windows, and it doesn't look like it's been used in years, it does look like they're doing some improvements on it. So they are fixing up this church for the town of Ringling, which is right down there.
It's a dying little town. Church window's broken, that place ain't been used in years.
So just as 50 years ago in the song Ringling Ringling, the streets are dusty, the bank is still torn down, and it's still a dying little town. However, that's not the way that this always was. Ringling, Montana, I believe it was founded in the year 1890, and it was named after John Ringling. Now, if Ringling sounds familiar, we always think of the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus, and that is the owner, or the founding name, of the town of Ringling. John Ringling was part of the circus. He owned the circus was named after him. And he also had owned a piece of the Northern Pacific Railroad that went through here. So that was the reason for the naming of the town, because the railroad used to come through here quite often. And even 50 years ago, Jimmy had said the trains only come through once or twice a month. Well, I believe, according to Wikipedia, that the last train that came through was back in 1980. So the trains don't come through at all anymore. I really don't think we are going to find a bar. I really don't think we're going to find a pile of beer cans that have been there for 27 years. And I can just imagine all the heartaches and tears in 27 years of beers.
We've done a lot of remodeling since we had it. The ceiling used to be that, like This was the ceiling we put across the building, but we opened it all up. Yeah.
Now this is something else.
And he sat right over in that corner and wrote his song. And about the fat bar made it. It's not me. Big Dorothy and Jim. Yeah.
Is there a pile of beer cans?
There used to be, and they were on that side of the post office. And okay. There's a property there, and I think it's sold. And but they buried those cans, and now they're starting to pop up.
Oh boy!
But there was a lot, and it was on that side of the post office. Well, the right next door, where the grass is tall. Somebody bought that property, and that's where the cans are popping up.
Oh my. Well, they're historic cans.
They
so
are.
He sat here. So now I had heard two different versions of what could have, why he was here. He was traveling through with Richard Brautigan, who was another artist from Key West, and they were in a rental car. Now, why did they stop in Ringling? I've heard two things. Either he was having car trouble and he had stopped to get it fixed,
right.
Or he was just on a trip. He was coming back from the West Coast. We know that.
Yeah.
But why did he stop off? We don't know.
And I don't know either. I mean, I haven't heard why he stopped here either. And of course, I wasn't here when he was here, but I, you know, have since moved here. Yeah. This bar has been a lot of things. Over there used to be the post office for a while. They used to hold church on that other side. Before we bought it on that side, that's where they fed the people, was on that side. Yeah, it's changed, that's for sure. There was no windows. There was two doors, that door over there, and like a half door here. And that's the original stove that came in the bar and heats the place.
Now, what was the name of the fat barmaid? You said a lady's name and a guy's name. That were they the previous owners?
They were, yeah,
okay.
A long time ago. Dorothy and Jim.
Okay.
Smith.
Dorothy and Jim Smith.
They called him Big Dorothy, but not terrific.
Yeah.
She was really a nice lady, and Jim was too.
So, cowboy and a dog.
And we think, I don't know who that is. I thought maybe it was Dan Bauer. Because he is a real cowboy. He lives up here and works for the Lane Ranch. But I don't know. You know, I had a dog too, a dollar dog. And now I got Kelly.
Yeah. This is really cool.
I'm back in the rental car and we hit the cruise control. Pretty soon the town was out of sight. But we left cowboy and dog, racing for a Ringling Friday night. Ringling, Ringling, you just slipping away. I wonder how many people will be there a year from today. God's streets are dusty.
So right now I am on Deep Creek Road. Here near Livingston, Montana, pretty much out in the middle of nowhere. Yeah, this is really God's country. But specifically, I'm coming up on what was the former property owned by Tom and Becky Mcguane'. In 1968, Tom Mcguane' had a very successful first published book called The Sportsman's Club. And with the proceeds of that book, he purchased 14 acres out here on this road for $14,500. And he called that ranch the Raw Deal Ranch. And over the next few years, the Raw Deal Ranch became the headquarters for the Key West crew of all those writers, artists, musicians that would come here to Montana and basically reconvene their Club Mandible and their Key West group. And out here at the time, there was so much talent that spent time out here. Richard Brautigan, Dink Bruce, Tom Corcoran, Tom Mcguane, obviously, Jim Harrison, So many. Russell Chatham loved it so much that he also purchased a property or rented a property just up the road. So there was so much out here at the time. And again, this was like the home base for these guys. Now, Becky Mcguane'S was quoted as saying that there were so many people out here. At one point, there were up to 27 people staying at the Raw Deal Ranch. Also, if we look at the timeline of this, Jimmy and Jane, at the time who were dating, they were not yet married, spent a lot of time up here. Jimmy said that with Living and Dying in Three-Quarter Time album, that he wrote most of that album while holed up in Montana. Jimmy Buffett spent months of 1973, 1974 here along this ranch. You can hear the running water behind me. So Jimmy Buffett spent many months here, wrote many songs here. And really specifically, when you think about it, if the song Come Monday, remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room for doubt. Jimmy and Jane were here quite a bit. Jimmy stayed in the barn area, and we're going to be coming up that on a moment. And there is a barn still on this property. I don't know if it's the same barn, but we can think, right? We can hope. So we're going to take a look at that here. So this was the property of Tom Mcguane'S. Him and his wife, now wife, Lori Buffett, in the mid-late 70s, purchased a new ranch, and they moved away from here. But at the time, nearby, not only did Tom Mcguane'S have his property here, but Becky Mcguane'S, who married Peter Fonda, had a ranch nearby. And Margot Kidder, who Tom Mcguane'S was married to and had a child with, she had a property nearby. So all of those properties were close by, and the idea was that Tom Mcguane'S son could walk, or the kids could walk to all of the different properties, whether it's the Fondas, the Mcguane'S, or the Kidders. So as we come up here, we see not only is it donkey crossing right there, but this was the former property, and there is a barn right there, and Jimmy Buffett stayed in a barn on this property. Now that would have been 50 years ago. So I do not know if that's the barn or not, but this was the former Raw Deal Ranch owned by Tom Mcguane'S. And like I said, 27 people staying here at one time, maximum. So much talent was here. It's really incredible. So there is a lot of history, there is a lot of talent. And look at this scenery. As an artist, how could you not be inspired to write some of the songs and stories and the things that came out from those men and women that spent so much time here? So, remember that night in Montana. Absolutely gorgeous. The former Raw Deal Ranch, owned by Tom Mcguane'S. And a frequent house guest and visitor, Jimmy Buffett. All right, so you may be asking yourself, why would I not include the song Miss You So Badly on my Jimmy Buffett Montana vlog? After all, it does begin, I guess it all blew up in Missoula, I guess there was no other way. Well, I looked into this, and what I discovered was that the song was written by both Jimmy Buffett and Fingers Taylor. However, Fingers Taylor had been the primary writer on the song, and Jimmy was quoted as saying he just filled in the gaps. So most of the things that were talked about in the song were more than likely Fingers' recollections. That, coupled with the fact that I did not want to have to drive 2 hours west just to take a picture of a Holiday Inn, made it a pretty simple decision. I wanted to focus on Livingston and the Raw Deal Ranch and all of those aspects of Jimmy Buffett lore. So, that being said, I do have, where is it? There it is. My Tuborg beer. I am not in a Holiday Inn full of surgeons. I don't know if they're going to be out to catch a stripper. I still don't want them cutting on me, but that's the reason that Miss You So Badly is not included in this vlog. Tuborg beer. Cheers. Well, all right, that is it. Thank you all for watching. There is so much Jimmy Buffett history in Montana. Remember, hit the subscribe, hit the like, hit the notifications, and we are going to be coming back with more Jimmy Buffett content very soon. Fins up, everyone. Bubbles up.
Remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room.